Hello, and welcome to the Online Teacher Guide podcast. I'm your host, Brittany, and I'm an online teacher, entrepreneur, and creator behind the Online Teacher Guide and the Online Teacher Guide podcast. The Online Teacher Guide podcast is for the individual who wants to become an online teacher, is already an online teacher, or a brick and mortar teacher. Hello and welcome. I am so happy that you are here with me. This interview with Miss Regi Wood, and she is at the Messy Little Classroom on Instagram, was recorded several weeks ago. So I hope that you all enjoy, and I want to let you know that there is a little bit of internet disconnect, but this episode is such an amazing episode. There are so many gems that I highly encourage you to have a pen and paper ready. It's very authentic. And I didn't edit it too much, so there will be some background noise. So let's get into it.
Welcome. Hello, everyone. This is the Online Teacher Guide, and I'm your host, Brittany Payne, and I am with Regi is just famous. In the online teacher world, I can't say it just enough. Regi is just the guru for anything that you need for virtual assistant. She makes TPT. She's a brick and mortar teacher. I mean, she's just amazing. So Regi, will you introduce yourself for the listener?
Yes. Hi, I'm Regi Wood. I'm at the Messy Little Classroom. Actually, I just registered yesterday as an LLC, so that's pretty cool. So I'm the Messy Little Classroom LLC mortar teacher. I teach first grade. I'm an online. I started with an online ESL company in Outschool as well. I am a wife. I am a mother. I have a 3-year-old son, and he is a hot mess, but I love him to death. And yes, I am a virtual assistant as well. So I have lots of arms in lots of different places.
Yeah. But your son is so cute.
Oh, thank you. He is. He's a sweetie.
So let's get back into your background, because that, I think to the listener who maybe just wants to get started online teaching or maybe teaching in a brick and mortar, it's like, wow, because you have been doing this, I mean, for many years. So what was your background before, and how did that sort of lead up to this point?
So I was an assistant teacher before in a brick and mortar classroom. So I did that for about 4.5 years while I was going to school to be a certified teacher. And then once I got my degree, a teacher retired in December, right as I was graduating. So I was lucky enough to move into my dream grade in my dream district. So that was really nice. But I started there in January, and I have been there now for 5 years, and I moved up from kindergarten to first grade. So I've only ever taught K and one, but I'm certified to teach K through six. So I started as brick and mortar, and then kind of realizing that I love teaching so much, I want to do it when I'm not teaching. So I started teaching online ESL, and that's where my whole online teacher journey started. Of course, with being a teacher and all of that before, I had all of the knowledge about, you know, child development and how to best teach students at those ages. It was a little learning curve with ESL and everything, but so my journey started with online ESL. And then this past summer, after COVID and all of that, I discovered Outschool after everyone started talking about it, because, you know, that was a big thing. And the online teacher space on Instagram, one thing is really, really popular, and Kid were really popular for a while. And then people started realizing the potential with Outschool, and that you could create your own classes and teach your own stuff and make more money. And so that became a thing. So I jumped onto that bandwagon, even though I told myself I wouldn't. I did anyway. And it's been really, really great. And so I actually connected with a fellow online teacher, Lainey Goff, and we connected on Instagram. I offered her a lot of help in the technical teacher side of things, with curriculum design and things like that. And so she ended up asking me to be her virtual assistant. So that's how that started. I started graphic design for her. I would help her design her slideshows for some of the things that she did. I do a little bit of social media work for her. So there's a lot of different things that I do with her that have also helped me with some of my newer things. So virtual assisting with her has kind of helped me understand how to formulate and create some of these type of online courses. And when I really got into my niche of classroom management and building this classroom management system that works all year long without needing to go from bribe to bribe to bribe to bribe, I started really honing in on that. And my social media has just really blown up. And I think that it's something that people need and something people want. And so a lot of those things that I've kind of learned in all of these years has really brought me to this point, which is going to be really cool to kind of see it all play out and see what happens.
Wow, that's amazing. And I don't want to sidetrack too much here, but that is what you're doing with the classroom management, I think is phenomenal. Going back to when I was in school, it's very much different than the students now. I mean, it was very much, I don't even know if like beating the student was illegal or legal still, I think in some states, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, that's pretty random, but I think that that was still a thing in certain like demographics, right? Right? To where now we've transitioned to like, there's so much for the students' needs, you know, we have pronouns, right? And it's taking that like old mentality and bringing it into 2021 after a pandemic, or actually whatever we're still in.
Yeah.
But that's a lot. So that's major. And you don't see that, right? And it's needed because times are different.
One of the first things that we talk about is mindset. What was your experience as a kid when you were in college to a 21st century classroom?
And I don't mean to trigger the listener when I was talking about like physical violence or anything, but that's actually pretty much a reality for people that are older millennials, or
right.
You weren't really allowed to express yourself, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So seeing how everything is transitioned now, it's different.
Yep. It is.
But you know, I'm here for it. I love it. I think it's pretty cool. I mean, I love it. So my next question would be, is what advice would you give to new teachers or teachers who want to get started maybe in the brick and mortar or online?
So if you want to get started in brick and mortar, I would say find a mentor and then obviously find a program that works for you. I could not quit my full-time job. So I had to find a program that allowed me to be an assistant teacher while going to school online. And so find a good program, find a good mentor, find somebody who you can kind of go through it with and get in the trenches with. We need good teachers. Yeah. We need good teachers in the school. So please, 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 if there is any part of you that wants to teach kids in a brick and mortar setting, in a public school setting, in a private school setting, I would say jump on it, because there is a critical teacher shortage and we just need good teachers. For online teaching, it's pretty similar. Get on Instagram, find the teacher community and listen to what they have to say. Find teachers on Instagram that you can get tips and tricks from. Find mentors that can refer you to these companies and then help you through the hiring process. That is crucial. It's huge. There are bonuses for referring to companies. I mean, it's like that with almost every online teaching company, but those teachers that refer you are referring you to help you. So make sure you utilize those referring teachers. Find a system that works for you. If you want to do early mornings, late nights, you know, find a company that matches. You don't have to do every company that everyone else is doing. You find one that matches what you want and meets your needs. And then I would say stay organized and stay kind of on top of your schedule, because they can tend to get a little bit wonky sometimes. You know, our schedules can kind of fluctuate a lot. So make sure that you're staying organized and that you know when your classes are. Set a bajillion alarms if you have to. That's what I have done in the past. And then I would say, of course, have your technology in order, have your internet connection in order, which clearly mine is not today. I don't know what's happening. But you know, make sure that you've got the technology that makes you look like a professional in what you're doing.
Absolutely. Wow. That's great. Great. Thank you. And so my next question is what would you want to tell the teacher who's currently maybe teaching in that brick and mortar or teaching online, but they want to level up, right? They're like, okay, I've hit my peak. I'm ready for the next one. What would you tell them?
I would say find something that you love so that it doesn't necessarily feel like a second job, but feels like an outlet for you. So like for me at first, it was helping Lainey, right? Mm-hmm. So I started helping her with like all the teacher things. And then she was asking me to do some graphic design, some things. And that was like a super creative outlet for me. And I loved that. So I was able to help her make some of those slideshows and presentations for her courses and everything. And so that was like fun for me. I got to do it. I did it in my free time. I made some extra money on the side. And it was like a fun kind of stress relief for me. So I would definitely say find something that feels like an outlet so that you don't feel like, okay, I'm working so much and I'm already working so much at my brick and mortar job and I'm already working such early mornings and I just don't, it's something that you're running to, not something that you're running from. So it took me a long time to think about it like this because I went from, oh, I want to leave the brick and mortar. I want to leave my brick and mortar job. I'm so tired of teaching all day long, you know, I don't want to run from that. Mm-hmm. I want to run to something else. If something else is going to replace my teaching income, I want to be running to it. So I want it to be something that is enjoyable for me, something that makes a difference, something that helps other people, something that serves other people. So I think that it's really important to make sure that whatever it is you're choosing to do outside of your brick and mortar or typical online teaching job, make sure it's something that you're running to.
Excellent. Wow, Regi, you are taking us to church.
That is so funny.
I love it. This is just, wow. Okay.
That's the big thing is, you know, I've gone from a couple of different things. I thought I was going to do like the big TPT thing and replace my income with Teachers Pay Teachers, but I'm quickly realizing that spending all that time making those resources is not really my cup of tea. So I make what I need for my classroom. I make what I need for what I'm doing now, but I'm realizing that what I'm doing now is what I'm running to, helping other teachers manage their classrooms, whether in person or online, and manage them well. Like that's what I'm running to. So it may take some time before you get there. It may take some time. You may invest in some programs that you realize this wasn't the best option for me. I'm not that person that's going to crank out 500 resources and make all this money on TPT. That's not me. It might be you. And if that's what you're running to, run, you know, but you just have to find what you want, what makes you feel like you're doing what you need to be doing, you know?
Yeah, excellent. And I think that's a great point too, because what I've mentioned on my YouTube and I think in other podcast episodes is you need more than one source of income,
right?
Especially when you're teaching, wherever, if it's a brick and mortar or if it's online, you definitely need one. And TPT is great, but it's not you're going to make immediate money and you're going to go ahead and stay at home. Absolutely not. And I agree with you. Like I have a TPT store, but I only put in the TPT store what I use in my classroom.
Yeah.
So resources that I've already made for my students and that I've used and created, I just put on there. But you do need, I've been researching it. You need like 500, right? Like,
Yeah. It is a lot. And I mean, and you're right. You do need, and unfortunately, brick and mortar, we should not need more streams of income. Sometimes we do. And that, I mean, over 80% of teachers have two or three jobs just to be able to make ends meet. And that is a whole nother issue in and of itself. But, you know, I do run a TPT shop and it is a small one. And I put on there the things that I already make or the things that I'm making for my brick and mortar classroom as well. So I do have that. I do have my virtual assisting. I do have, you know, this new peaceful classroom thing that I've been working on. So I do have multiple different things. You don't have to only have one big thing outside of the classroom. You can have ever many of those things that you want, as long as it's something or as long as it's many things in our case, you know, that make you feel happy, that make you feel like you're not doing extra work. Because the truth is, on top of my brick and mortar job, which is 40 hours a week, because I do not stay past contract hours, that's 40 hours a week. I do, you know, 5 to 10 hours with Lainey and then all of those other hours on my own stuff. So, I mean, I'm probably working 60 hours a week, you know, which is a lot of work, but it doesn't feel like a lot of work. And I am able to put it in pockets of time where I haven't had to take a lot of time away from my family, which is also really, really nice. Another thing I would think about is when you start your teacher's like Instagram, I would have a separate Instagram for personal and then for teacher, or for whatever it is that you're doing. You may get to the point where brands start to reach out for you for like paid collaborations. And that's another stream right there where you can, you know, brands will pay you to, you know, whatever they call it, advertise like their products, you know, they may send you free stuff and ask you to advertise it that way. So there are several different avenues you can go. But my main piece of advice would be whatever you choose, however many of those things you choose, make it something that really, really makes you feel like you're making a difference and doesn't feel so much like work.
Excellent. Ah, phenomenal. Again, the church. Yes. I am here for it. Can you tell us about your upcoming events that you have?
So the biggest one is July 25th. That is the release of my Peaceful Classroom workshop. So it's a 5-pillar system for proactively managing a classroom. This can work in person. If you're brick and mortar, it can also work online. There are parts of it that obviously would not apply to an online teacher because you're not in person with your kids, such as the calm down corner, things like that, structures we would have in a brick and mortar setting that we don't really have in an online setting. But the principles and the core values of this program, this system, work just as well for online teachers as they would for brick and mortar teachers. So that's the big one. It's July 25th. That workshop is a whopping $10. So I'm just all about serving. And I want this in the hands of teachers so that they can bring the joy back into their classrooms, whether it's online or in person, and start to really, really enjoy that teaching again. That's my biggest one right now. I'm also still working with Lainey. So she has the Scale to Success Summit that's coming up August 5th and 6th, right? 5th and 6th. And so I'm working with her on that. I'm helping her with her presentation. We've been talking about, you know, different ways to promote and things like that. So I'm doing that as well. And then of course I start back at work at the beginning of August. So.
Wow. Yeah. It's pretty random side note. When does school start back for you?
For me, the kids come back August 6th. I go back August 4th.
Wow. Wow. That is soon.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, great. Well, thank you so much. And is there anything else that you want to tell the listener?
I would just say continue doing what you're doing. I mean, continue working. It takes time and consistency, but when you really, really find what your thing is, it just feels like just energy. I mean, it just gives you so much energy and direction. Again, I would really recommend to utilize the Instagram community. It is unmatched. The teacher community on Instagram is absolutely unmatched. And of course, you know, these podcasts, the Online Teacher Guide podcast, I mean, all of these different online teachers that are coming out with these amazing things, just soak them up for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. And the last question I had is, how do you do it all? But you actually told us how you do it all. This doesn't feel like work to you. This is something that you're running to. This is your passion. I mean, you love it. And you can hear the love and excitement and everything in your voice.
Right. And I mean, there are some things like managing my time well, you know, I manage my time very well when I haven't really this summer. Whew, this summer's been a different story. Yeah. But like when I'm at work, I do not work past my contract hours. I leave my school at 3:30, between 3:30 and 4 o'clock. Uh-huh. You know, I do not get there early. I do not stay past contract hours. And that helps a lot. And it forces me to manage my schedule while I'm there so that then when I'm out of there, when I'm not at work anymore, I can focus on the other things. And I time block. So I have an hour of block of on this thing, an hour where I work on this thing, an hour where I clean my house, an hour mm-hmm. where I, you know, so we have these different time blocks, and it just really helps to manage your time and to manage what you're getting done in a way that helps you to get all of it done. So on top of it not feeling like work, there also are some things that I utilize that allow me to be able to focus, because I know that us as teachers, right, we can have all these ideas.
Thank you so much. This was amazing. I know that so many people will need this episode. I mean, you just took us to church, first and foremost. You broke everything down so eloquently. I mean, thank you. So many gems.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thank you for having me. This was great. This was my first like official podcast interview. So that is super exciting. And I'm happy it was with you. I just love you so much. Brittany and I have been friends for a while on Instagram. So it's nice to like watch you do all of your stuff and be able to support you too. So
oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Yes, it's been great.